Hi everyone, this is Shubham, and in this today's video I'm going to talk to you guys about a different automation tool. So simultaneously we are on verge to complete our Cypress tutorial, where we have already almost covered 70% of its part, and we are just pending with the dashboard and generation of our Mocha report, and little bit of API testing also. XHR testing is I need to cover with Cypress. That I'm gonna continue. I'm gonna keep on posting lecture and tutorial on that particular stuff. Simultaneously, I was thinking to talk to you guys about this hyper automation related stuff. So what is hyper automation? So hyper automation is called as RPA, robotic process automation. So with Cypress, Selenium, Protractor, we have been seeing, or RhinoRx or Catalan, there are a lot of tools, Ready API, Rest Assured. So I've been trying to see over there with these tools, we can automate our web application. We can automate using APM mobile automation, mobile application. And then API automation also can be achieved using Postman, Ready API, Rest Assured related libraries and whatnot. What is hyper automation? So today we are seeing this hyper automation has come up, and this has been a coined term by the people who wanna reduce the manual intervention by humans on their day-to-day activities. So right now we've been seeing a lot of web front-end UI API automation stuff. What about desktop related applications like mainframe, SAP, or what about your day-to-day tasks? Like suppose you need to extract some data from your image, you need to extract some data from your PDF, you need to do some admin related stuff on your Windows based machine. So for that, robotic process automation term has been coined. So these small robots have been developed, have been generated to reduce the manual or human intervention of these jobs, like taking a text from email or automating the email related SMTP protocol. Like where, suppose, with an example I'll give you, where as an HR, if you receive a lot of emails from a lot of candidates who want to apply for that particular job, so how you want to channelize it? You want to channelize with some kind of keywords, like suppose Selenium keyword has been given to you, and you want to filter out those email based on that. So this is going to be a tedious task, right? If you're going to do using manual intervention. So that's why the term has been coined up, that is RPA, robotic process automation. So robotic process automation, this is the tool which we're going to talk about in our new lecture, new particular stuff, which I am going to try to lecture you or teach you as a beginner from today, in this very first lecture of today. So for the first step, you need to download this UI path, because we're gonna majorly work on this particular tool. So to download UI path, you just need to go to their official website. You need to click on this try UI path for free. When you're gonna click on it, it will give you multiple options like 60 days free trial license, or a UiPath Pro, UiPath Studio, UiPath Basic. But you have to log in. You have to log in through your Google or account, or through your LinkedIn account, or through your email, and then you can download it. So while after downloading, how UiPath is gonna look like, you need not to add any dependencies, any command you need to run. It just automatically open you when you're gonna run that like exe file. And this is how it will open the UiPath Studio. Now there are a lot of terms, right? Process, library, test automation, template. We're going to discuss each and everything. First, we're going to click on process, because in RPA or in UiPath, we call our, see, in Cypress Selenium related stuff, we call it test spec, or our folder structure, or our project structure, right? In Cypress, you're going to call that particular test or spec process. You're gonna click on the process, which is a new process. I'm gonna give this process the name of simple process, simple learning process. And this is gonna ask you where you wanna store it. So I'm trying to store it over here. You can give any description based on the language you wanna go ahead. You can select your language as well. And you're gonna click on create. So it will restore your dependency. The injections of dependency is gonna place into a particular studio. And then you will see how is it going to look like. So this is our main page of UiPath, where you can see your project structure. So in the project structure, you see if you want to automate Excel, You can use Excel activities, then it will automate, like dependencies are there for your mail activities as well, system activities and your automation related activities, which is web based or API based. And main.xml, we're going to write your, I guess, the test case. We're going to drag and drop your related activities over here. So then you see second particular option, activity. So in this, you see a lot of activity. So suppose I want to read something from Excel. What are you going to write? Read Excel. See, read CSV. You're going to just take it. You're going to drop it over here. Or this is going to be command. So you can use any kind of command. So read cell. See, you double clicked on it. It has been pushed to your main XML file where you just going to give your sheet number, your path where from where the sheet needs to be imported in your process. And then you will do manipulations on that. Snippets and snippets, it will show you how the exemplary test case they have automated. So suppose you're going to click on calculator.xml. So this is our sequence. It will take your windows. So through this, through example snippets, you can learn how the process has been automated. So first is going to be keep the stuff in do while loop. So do. Then the process like click on 4 button, click on add button, then click on 5. So it's going to result you to 9, right? And then you can have your OCR text. You can extract text from particular screens. So this is the basic example. They have shown how to automate this process. You have recording stuff, you have screen scraping. They can scrap the data from particular image. Data scraping has been given as well. So there are a lot of things with this studio. I'm going to discuss each and everything which has been present over here. So again, what is hyper automation, RPA? So robotic process automation is basically small chunks of robot has been created to reduce human or manual intervention. With an example of suppose being an HR, you need to filter a lot of stuff that has to be avoided. You can automate that process. Being a person, being a teacher, if you want to filter out the assignments of a student, you can filter out using this. You want to scrape a lot of values from your text or from your image file or some image, you can use UiPath and it will give you the result of that. So there are a lot of things UiPath or RPA has been used for, and this is going to be our future. So we're going to discuss it in our next lecture, and we're going to create one simple XAML file to automate little stuff, and we'll see how does this work out. Till then time, thank you so much, and we're going to keep continuing with our Cypress related lecture as well. You can see in that particular Cypress related playlist for RPA or UiPath, I'm going to create a different playlist and I'm going to post in our YouTube channel, and then from there you can have access. And if any feedback, you can just always comment and let me know the feedback of yours. Thank you so much.